Hello everyone, Gordablaze here, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone for the Game Boy Color. In the last episode, we tried to go looking around in the forbidden area of the library with the invisibility cloak on, but, well, we found out the books have ways of alerting people should we do that. So we escaped from the library, found the Mirror of Erised, and, well, Dumbledore kind of just sent us kindly back to bed. But now it's moved on to Easter break, and, well, we're off to Hagrid's hut now to learn more about you-know-who, not Voldemort, and the you-know-what, the title of the game. So anyways, I'm going to head there via the hospital wing to heal, and also Fred and George's shop to just buy a few things, so yes. I'll see you along the way then. Fred and George have increased their item supply again. Some very expensive items here. Very good should you get them. But again, very expensive. Okay, you know what? Before we go to Hagrid, I've healed up already at the hospital wing, but we have an octopus paddle, we have a bicorn horn, we have a mandrake root, we have the brass caldron. Let's see if we can make a grand pepper up potion and show off the potion making stuff. So let's see, I just need the brass caldron. Then the octopus powder, the bicorn horn, and the mandrake roots. Great, you created grand pepper potion. Oh, that was simpler than I thought. I thought there was going to be like a potion making minigame or something you'd have to do. Oh well, there we go, that is how you do things with the cauldron, so yeah. Don't know what would happen if we threw random things in there, don't really want to find out since we have only like one or two of each of the items. But yeah, there we go, we created a grand pepper potion with the ingredients we have, so woohoo! Anyways, now I will see you down at Hagrid's hut. Okay, something that I was just confirming that I couldn't quite remember. The plants outside of Hogwarts have their items respawn on them after a while. If it's things like asphodel root, mandrake root, and the like. So if you are in need of them, you can go and track down the plants again to go and get the different items. And we just got Monk's Hood. We did not get that earlier, did we? Okay, here we are at Hagrid's hut. Head on in, we can actually explore Hagrid's hut at long last. Walk around, see Hagrid's giant furniture and giant bed. Hey, he has a Riches and Wizards card. Cool. Anyways, let's head around here. Just see his different furniture. The bed for his dog, Fang. I bet Hagrid has some interesting things to tell us about the stone. There you are, Harry. We have been waiting for you. I'm sorry I had to end the episode and then took care of a few other things as well. Sorry, guys. Alright, to answer your question, some of the teachers cast enchantments to guard the stone. McGonagall, Flitwick, Sprout, Quirrell, and Snape. Snape! Snape helped protect the stone, even though you think he's trying to steal it. Snape won't try to until he learns how to get past Fluffy. Why is it so hot in here? Hagrid, what's this? That? Oh, it's a dragon's egg. Where did you get it? I won it from a stranger. You seem to be glad to be rid of it. I've been reading up on how I'm taking care of it. Norwegian Ridgeback, very rare. It's adding you the evolution music. I think I will name him Norbert. Norbert? You have to be careful, Hagrid. I think Malfoy might know what you're up to, or know what you're doing. He almost bit through my boot just now. The poor little fellow must be hungry. Well, he did just hatch, and it's a dragon. What does he like to eat? Slytherins, I hope? Nah, they make him sick. The books I read say he likes chickens. Could you go out and fetch five of them? Fetch me five of them? Sometimes those wild ones on the ground. Sure, how hard could catching chickens be? Well, here we go. We have Norbert the Norwegian Ridgeback here. And now, for one of the most amusing parts, we have to find five chickens for Norbert here, okay? And, well, oh, he teleported, and now he's ripping up Hagrid's pillows, so I guess we better hurry a bit. No. What are you doing here, Malfoy? I'm gathering a bouquet for a soon-to-be-deporting student and his friends. That's not good. Anyways, if we head out here, onto Hogwarts grounds, it will suddenly be filled with chickens, just running about everywhere. Find a chicken, and push A on it. The chickens are a boss. I'm dead serious. The chickens are a boss. However, flipendo uno. They're chickens. The chickens are a boss, but they are a complete pushover trio of a boss that you don't even need to expend spell points to get rid of. Except for that one survived, holy cow, that's the first time I've ever seen a chicken survive a spell. Fine, flipendo duo on you then. The best part is though, is you have to catch five of these guys, and they give out, even though they're absolutely pathetic, because they are counted in the game as a boss, they give out the experience of a boss. Yes, I'm serious. Look at that. Experience, 120, only 4 sickles, and ostrich feathers, which never figured out what the ostrich feathers are used for. But there we go. We gain a new level, everything plus 1, stamina plus 9, and we receive a chicken. And now we basically need to just go hunting around Hogwarts for a bunch of chickens that are just conveniently all loose in the ground at the same time. There we go, there's one. Come here, chicken. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. There we go. Feel the chickens. Feel the 5 damage. And the 0 damage. And the 0 damage. It tallies up to 500, if you want to believe that. Anyways, yeah, these guys are complete pushovers. I'll see you here. Let's just speed this up. Play some zany, wacky, silly music, and just speed this up, shall we? Oh, by the way, quickly though, if you need to level grind, this is a perfect place to, because the chickens can barely do anything to you and they give a ton of experience. So if you're behind on levels, feel free to grind. I think I'm going to grind a few levels here myself. So anyways, cue the zany silly music.
We'll be right back.
Okay. One final battle against the chickens, who I've been doing a wonderful job of level grinding against, as two of them fail to attack me at all, is that since we have 105 magic points now, we can now use the move Mucus Ad Nauseam, so I can finally at long last show it off. Basically, it takes 80 magic points to use, but with it, you can poison your opponent to start taking damage at the end of every turn, just like you do when you're poisoned. So yes, unfortunately, like I said though, it costs a huge amount of spell points, so it's fairly impractical at the moment, but that's what Mucus Ad Nauseam does, and I'm finally able to show it off. Anyways, let's just finish these guys off. That guy goes down from poison. And let's just incendio this one. Have some fried or cooked chicken tonight. This chicken is oh so good and delicious. Now, I'm curious, how many chickens do I have? I only needed 5. How many did I fight? How many chickens did I fight? Where is it? 14! Oh, okay. Yeah, I may have fought a bit more than I was supposed to. In fact, you know what? Make it 15. Just for the heck of it. And there we go, yet another new level gained. And our 15th chicken. These things infinitely respawn until you return to Hagrid's hut, so yeah, we're level 26 now. Not the best way to money grind, but for level, definitely one of the best ways in the game. Against chickens, of all things, which is downright hilarious that they decided that these chickens that you had to track down needed to be bosses. They give a ton of experience out, despite being complete pushovers. Anyways, here you go, Hagrid. We have way more chickens than you need. You give up a chicken, 2 chickens, 3 chickens, 4 chickens, 5 chickens. Thanks, Harry. Little Norbert is fading away to nothing. He's eating your pillows. Hagrid, he's grown in the short while I was gone. In a week, he'll be as big as your hut. Malfoy could expose you at any moment. I know I can't keep him forever, but I can't turn him loose on his own either. My brother Charlie is doing dragon research in Romania. Maybe he can find a place for him. Let's send Hedrick to him with a note. How about it, Hagrid? Well, I suppose that's the way it has to be. You caught chickens for Hagrid's scaly new friend Norbert. Entirely by coincidence, a new car combination is now available in the Wizard's Car Collectors Club. Like, this one is just like, yeah, this one's just coincidence. Just, unlike all the others where it's making some sort of pun, it's just like, nope, this one just happened to happen. And time passes. Before... back in the library, and hey look, Hedrick's here, and guys, please notice Malfoy is watching you in plain sight. And that's sadly all Hedrick does in this entire game, besides sit around in the item spots, yeah. Anyways, she has a message from Charlie. Read it, Ron. Dear Ron, I'll be glad to take the dragon, but it won't be easy. The best thing to do will be to send him over with some friends of mine who are coming next week. Could you get the Ridgeback up to the tallest tower at midnight on Saturday? They can meet you there and take him while it's still dark. Send an answer as soon as possible. The reason why we have to do this all in the darkness is it turns out a Norwegian Ridgeback is actually an illegal dragon to own in the United Kingdom. Love, Charlie. So yes, they have to do this as a fly-by-night sort of operation so they don't get caught. But yeah, we can use the invisibility cloak to get him to the tower. I think it's big enough. To cover 2 of us and Noble. I'll send Hedrick back with a reply. Now let's go tell Hagrid. How do we really not notice Malfoy? Anyways, that is it for today. We have current quest, chase the escape Norbert. Well, you know what we're doing next week. Next episode, guys. We get to go and chase Norbert, who has apparently escaped, so says the current quest. But for now, this is God Ablaze, and I've had enough time, fun time chasing down chickens and having a blast. Sadly, none of my spells leveled up, but I leveled up a bunch. However, it's kind of getting late here where I am, so I'm just going to end this recording session now and go to bed. But I hope you enjoyed this episode, everyone, and I will see you next time. God Ablaze out.